Welcome everyone to a Critical Review, and today we have ArcaniA, previously known before 2014 as ArcaniA Gothic 4. Anyway guys, ArcaniA or ArcaniA Gothic 4, I will persist in calling it Gothic 4 or ArcaniA Gothic 4, as that's when I played the game and, well, the first time I played the game and the last time was ArcaniA, so I'll call them by either name. But the game first came out in 2010, late 2010, and it's basically, it's an open world RPG, much akin to Skyrim, except third person, I guess. Well, much akin to the Elder Scrolls series in general, actually. Pardon. But the first thing I may point out here is the graphics. The graphic style, I would expect it from a 2008 or 2009 game. I would not, like, I would expect better from a game from 2010. I don't know, maybe I got a bit spoiled in 2010 and 2011 by the likes of other games like Black Ops and Battlefield 3 and the Elder Scrolls Skyrim, of course. But the graphics just aren't up to scratch for its time. So at the time of this video, the actual game's almost 4 years old now, but its soundtrack is very good. Just going right along here, the soundtrack is basically Skyrim level, almost Skyrim level. Like, and Skyrim was probably one of the biggest letdowns in the Elder Scrolls series in terms of soundtrack when compared to Oblivion and Morrowind. But so it's Skyrim level soundtrack, which is decent, but it is rather monotonous and there's not much there. There's not much of a actual continuation of a varied soundtrack, so you'll constantly hear, when you're fighting, you'll constantly hear the soundtrack in the background right now. And just in that part, what I would like to point out there is that one arch demon thing has such terrible AI. That AI programming was so bad. By the way guys, this is the prologue, this is not the actual game. But the actual game will be coming up shortly. But the AI is so bad. This was on hard difficulty as well. I mean, you can't die in this bit of the game, but it's not much different in the actual game itself either. The combat is ridiculously easy. Which isn't very good for a RPG, believe it or not. Because even in Skyrim, I mean, their expert wasn't that hard, but you go up to legendary, you're dead. Literally dead. So there were a lot of things lacking in this game that I would have expected better from. But yeah, again, continuing on with the combat. Combat, as I said, is ridiculously easy, but the AI doesn't attribute to that at all. Like, if you look here, he's just constantly getting attacked and then use the shield, just walk to the side and then, yeah, he doesn't turn or do anything. So yeah, and then the actual intro of the game was probably the best bit. Like, this bit now, I think personally, was the best bit in the game. I did not like the rest of the game. I did not finish the rest of the game because I did not like it. Here we go. We skipped to one of the skill tree bits. We just left the intro behind here. But this was after. Oh, excuse me. This was after. Well, this is still the first quest in the game, and this is after the first part of the main of the first quest. This is the second part of it, and here I'm just showing off the skill tree, which doesn't consist of much. I mean, I thought it was really weird that I couldn't get sneak till, like, a certain level. But yeah. And I think here we go off to go fight some goblins. So this is the actual game. As you can see, my equipment isn't nearly as good as in the intro. But yeah, and the camera zooms out. I must admit, I do like how the automatic camera goes, how it just zooms in when your sword is put away or whatever weapon you're using is put away, but I don't like how I have no control over that. That is something that really annoys me here, with this game. And I like the hotbar, and where it displays your health, stamina, health, and magic. I like that. That was useful. And same with the map up the top, even though the map was itself a very, very vague map. I still thought it was useful, but yeah. And here we see some of the graphics. And then I was actually trying to turn around it. It seems this game, even for like an RPG, and I would mainly call this game a slasher, much akin to Witcher. So it's kind of like a cross between Witcher and Skyrim, I guess. Or just, like, any Witcher 1 or Witcher 2. But Skyrim, it has a lot to do with Skyrim as well. And it's just, yeah, but in that bit, that was terrible. I don't understand, but I don't think it supports, like, very much multitasking in terms of combat. Like, so I was pressing left click there, but I couldn't turn around, even though I had already, pressing S on my keyboard. And by the way, guys, this game, as much to my knowledge, does not have controller support. So if you wanted to play it with a controller, sorry, you're a bit out of luck there.
I caught the goblins. They are dead.
Oh, he's gonna interrupt me, now, but that's alright. Really, we'll just talk over him here, but This also annoys me, these, like, the talking and stuff. I was spoiled by Mass Effect and Mass Effect 2. I haven't played Mass Effect 3, but I want to. Mass Effect and Mass Effect 2, the voice acting, was just brilliant. And then, whereas here, and also the facial movement, I cut out a bit of the before this, where we were doing the first trial, but the amount of pain I went through by looking at this person's face, and such terrible graphics as well. And this is, by the way, guys, this is all on maximum graphics, 1080p. So yeah, it has a good story. I must admit, the story is very good, but very badly explained, like, to the point where I wasn't even sure what the point of starting on this island was, and I still am not that sure. But yeah, it was painful to play, I must admit. I personally would never finish it, and probably will never play it again after this review. But yeah, it's really,
you, the advisor of Robar the Third.
Yeah, that bit really pains me, that just the facial movement. The voice act, like the actual voice actors, they're alright. Like, I would say average. It was painful to go through though after Mass Effect though. And considering Mass Effect and Mass Effect 2 are both the same price as this game on Steam at least, which is $20. I would say go just buy Mass Effect or Mass Effect 2, because it's going to be such a much better experience than this. Coming up there's going to be some bow combat as well. But yeah, that was, the bow combat was probably better than the hand-to-hand. And here we go, like, oh yeah, attack the Leaf Hunter tribe, suddenly they're all after you, these goblins. So yeah, That's another thing. I guess that was a decent thing. But, yeah. And here I start getting wrecked. I don't know why. Yep, and then, yep, okay, then I actually start moving properly. And this just makes me think where the Elder Scrolls Online got this from. One gold on each enemy? One gold? And this, yeah. I wanted to not cut this out because I wanted to show this off. I almost got stuck there. Invisible walls. You would not expect an invisible wall to be there, but there was one, wasn't there? That made me really annoyed, and it probably, this game had, could have improved a lot. I mean, the graphics were alright, they were actually half decent, but the actual gameplay and just the bugs in the actual game that I found by 2 hours of play were just, horrendous, and they were numerous. They weren't, like, a few here and there, but, there were just so many of them, and it really annoyed me. And here we are, just running around the town, and that foliage disappearance, that was another thing that threw me out a bit, that just the foliage disappearing after you don't look at it, and still in your field of view as well, and it's just, why would you do that in a game? I don't understand, and here I skip past because I didn't want to see how badly the facial, when they were speaking with her. Because, that one person, Ivy, her name is, was just horrible. Absolutely horrible facial structure, and, oh, not so much facial structure, but, the actual mouth movements and stuff were just painful to watch. The game, I don't know what I would give it, in on a scale of just, like, if, I was just scaling it on its graphics, would probably be, for the time, probably a 7. Because they were still decent, but they weren't good enough for its time. They were about a year or two behind, what the games from 2010 were, in terms of graphics. But the game itself, just to sum it up, was ridiculously easy. It was also painful, just painful to watch. And that, okay, the inventory, I forgot to mention the inventory, probably what I would have wanted from Skyrim. That inventory is very clear. And when I was saying, speaking of combat, look at the bow. That's how quickly you win. That's how quickly I completed that. And then shoot the goblins a couple of times. And then you just walk backwards. It's so broken. I mean, in real life, you could probably do this, but they wouldn't wind up for an attack, would they? But, so the actual game, combat ridiculously easy, graphics below average there. They were average, below average, around there. One gold. That's all I'm gonna say about that. One gold. And then you get 14 golden chests, but one gold. The actual, in terms of, like, foliage disappearing and stuff, that was horrendous. That was just absolutely horrendous. It completely wrecked the immersiveness of the game. In terms of the actual overlaid map, which I only used once and cut out of this recording, that was good. That was probably a very good part of the, map, but in terms of an overall score, I'd give Arcania / Arcania Gothic 4 a 6.2 or 62%, because it's worth playing. But if you want something hard, look elsewhere. You are not going to get it from this game. You play on Gothic difficulty, it's still not hard. Yeah, guys, if you want something difficult, don't buy this game. If you want to have a look at subpar graphics, or if you want to run this on a older machine and like to have a good story that isn't very well explained and you like delving in a bit too, be my guest, this would be a great game. But for me, it's just not the style of game that I'm looking for and just not something that I would personally play. Anyway guys, see you later, hope you enjoy the rest of the recording.
No trial, my son. You will need an engagement bangle for Ivy and her consent.
A bangle? I guess I should talk to Holwyn about it. Maybe he can help me.
You do that, my son.